Today marks 1 year since the coronavirus was officially declared a global pandemic. The virus was first identified in Wuhan, China, and then swept across the world, killing more than 2.6 million people. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Aya Galal is live right by St. Mary's Hospital in Waterbury. Aya, we hear they're holding a special event today to mark all of those lives lost. Tell us about it.
Nicole, that's right. And this last year has been filled with so much sorrow and devastation. So hospital workers will be gathering to honor those who've lost their lives to COVID-19 across the country. More than 529,000 people have died from the pandemic.
365 days ago, the COVID-19 outbreak was officially declared a worldwide pandemic. Critics say Chinese authorities worked harder to suppress information about COVID-19 than to contain it. The World Health Organization maintains it issued early warnings, but countries didn't listen.
Yes, maybe we need to shout louder. But maybe some people need hearing it.
Investigators from the World Health Organization spent nearly a month in China, but still haven't pinpointed the origins of the virus. 1 year later, vaccines are providing shots at hope.
We're now on track to have enough vaccine supply for every American adult by the end of May.
The CDC says case numbers may be beginning to decline again after plateauing at high levels. Average hospital admissions and COVID-19 deaths are also down over the last week, according to the agency.
And so far, 1 in 10 Americans have been fully vaccinated. So later on this morning, hospital workers from St. Mary's Hospital, as well as first responders, will be gathering to reflect on the last year. Healthcare workers will also be honored, and they'll also be remembering those who passed away from the virus. Live in Waterbury this morning, Aya Galal, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.